Let us discuss temperature. I hope all of you might have covered in early classes that temperature is a degree of hotness or coldness. Of a body. By measuring temperature, we can see that how hot or how cold the body is relative to another bodies in the surrounding. Or we can also state based on thermal agitation, which we have just now studied, that on increasing temperature, thermal agitation will increase. So we can say about temperature, we can write it is a measure of energy of random oscillations of particles of a body. So, temperature can be given as either degree of hotness or coldness, or we can state it is a measure of energy of random oscillations of particles of a body. Now, the important point about temperature we need to study is measurement of temperature. We talk about measurement of temperature. I hope all of you have heard about thermometers, which are used for measurement of temperature. But the important thing is when we talk about measurement of temperature of a physical object, we first need to measure some property of the object which varies with temperature. Or you can say for a system, or you can also call bodies or different objects, we measure temperature by measuring some property of system or bodies which varies with the temperature. Like if we talk about the length of an object, area of an object or volume of an object, we know well that it varies with temperature. Just now we have studied in thermal expansion. Similarly, there are many more parameters like pressure of a gas. When a gas in a container is supplied some heat due to which its temperature increases, then automatically its pressure will also increase. There are so many things like in a different way, resistance of a wire. Or in some cases, refractive index of a material, which also depends on temperature. As you change the temperature, refractive index change it. So all such properties, when we measure by some physical instrument, using these properties of a physical object, which varies with temperature, we can indirectly find out the temperature, how temperature is varying. Correspondingly, these parameters will vary. So, by measuring these properties and variation with temperature, we can indirectly find temperature. Here we can state that the science of measurement of temperature is called thermometry. Now, when we talk about thermometry, the only thing we have to study is how temperature is measured. As we have just now studied, to measure temperature of a substance, we measure some property of the substance which varies with temperature, and on the basis of that measurement, we find out by some analytical relations what will be the variation in temperature, and accordingly, temperature scale is calibrated. We can state devices used for temperature measurement are called thermometers. You are already aware about thermometers. The most common thermometer is mercury in glass thermometer, when we talk about mercury in glass thermometer, it is based on expansion of mercury. When temperature of mercury increases, it expands and it fills the space in the narrow tube, and in that particular tube aside, a temperature scale is fixed based on which we can find out the temperature. Mercury in glass thermometer is like, there is a glass tube at the bottom of which a small bulb is there in which mercury is filled. And when temperature of this mercury bulb increases, mercury expands and fills up the space in the narrow tube. And just beside to this narrow tube, a temperature scale which is already calibrated, a pre-calibrated scale is scribed on which we can measure the temperature. Whichever is the temperature reading measured by such a thermometer depends on the accuracy of thermal expansion, and for a small variation of temperatures within the given range of room temperature, such thermometers are quite efficient. Along with this, there are many other thermometers, like one is a pressure thermometer. In case of pressure thermometer, a glass bulb is taken in which a gas is filled, and it is connected to again a narrow tube with a temperature scale on it. Again, mercury is filled in it, and when temperature of gas increases, its pressure increases, and due to rise in pressure, the mercury is pushed and mercury will rise in the narrow glass tube beside which the temperature scale is there. There is also a thermometer which gives us quite efficient reading, but not as accurate as a mercury in glass thermometer. And similarly, lot many thermometers are made in which we use some property of a physical substance which varies with temperature. Like in case of mercury in glass thermometer, we are using its expansion property. When we talk about gas contained in a glass bulb, here we are using its pressure as the property which varies with temperature, and due to the pressure mercury is measuring. You can see here we just ignore the expansion of mercury because temperature of mercury is directly not expanding. It is that of gas which is increasing. So it will not expand due to direct rise in temperature. So here mercury will rise due to the excess pressure of gas due to rise in temperature. Similarly, there are many thermometers which can be made. Now we'll discuss different temperature scales which are used for measurement of temperature. And we can state to define a temperature scale, two fixed points which are generally taken arbitrarily, which are specified at steam point and ice point. Like for Celsius scale, you can state steam point is taken as 100 degrees Celsius and ice point is taken as 0 degrees Celsius. So, for a temperature scale, whenever we wish to define, first two arbitrary fixed points are specified at a steam point and ice point for water. For different kind of temperature scales, we can state ice point and steam points can vary, but these can be interconverted by a temperature scale relationship which can be given as, for all temperature scales, we can use, as an identity, we can use temperature reading minus ice point divided by steam point minus ice point. This remains constant. you can write for all scales. This identity we use for interconversion of various reading of temperature between different scales, and this is also termed as thermometric scale identity. Is also abbreviated as TSI. This is the thermometric scale identity, which is generally used for conversion of temperatures between different temperature scales. Let's list out some standard common temperature scales which are used in general measurement. In common measurements, we can say that we use 5 different types of temperature scales are used. These are, we just list up the temperature scales as well as their symbol and ice point and steam point. The very first is Celsius scale. In Celsius scale, the symbol we use for notation is degree Celsius. Its ice point is taken as 0 degree Celsius and steam point is taken at 100 degree centigrade. Second we use is Kelvin scale. The symbol used for Kelvin scale is K and its ice point is taken as 273.14 K, which is commonly taken as 273 K also, and the steam point is 373.14 K, which is an absolute value. This is also called absolute scale. Or this temperature is also called absolute temperature. And again, be careful, in common calculations we use 273 and 373 as ice point and steam point for Kelvin scale. Other is Fahrenheit scale. In Fahrenheit scale, the symbol we use as degree Fahrenheit and ice point steam point for Fahrenheit scale are 32 degree Fahrenheit and 212 degree Fahrenheit. And the fourth one is Reaumur scale. For this, the symbol we use degree Reaumur. So it's ice point and steam point are 0 degree Reaumur and 80 degree Reaumur. The last one, which is also common, is Rankine scale. And the symbol used is RA, which stands for Rankine. And for Rankine scale, ice point is 460 Rankine and steam point is 672 Rankine. These are the standard ice point and steam point defined for these scales, which can be used for interconversion of temperature readings between various scales. Let's have some examples also. Like for a common example, we can state, if we are given to convert a reading of a Fahrenheit scale to Celsius scale. This can be very easily taken, like in solution we can state by thermometric scale identity we use. If reading of Celsius scale is C, then we can use C minus 0 by 100 minus 0 is equals to, if reading of Fahrenheit scale is F, this can be written as F minus 32 by 212 minus 32. So on solving this, you can see we'll be getting C is equals to 100 by 180 multiplied by F minus 32. So this will give us a relationship between Celsius and Fahrenheit scale, which is Celsius reading is equals to 5 by 9 multiplied by Fahrenheit reading minus 32. This would be the answer to our problem, that is the reading of Fahrenheit scale to Celsius scale. So if Fahrenheit reading is F, the Celsius reading can be given by using this relation.